very easy in the heat of the excitement of the game to lose yourself, to stop observing, and also to try to think too much or enforce your will too much. But by trying to achieve a certain goal within the game or overthinking it, you're actually harming the capability of the game to teach you. So a game should not be played stupidly or without attention either, but it is about the observation of the game. It's about what it does with you, how it transforms you. It is a journey which you're taking, a journey full of hope, defeat, success, and all these challenges, all these powers can work upon you. And they can transform you, they can prepare you for making this journey, not just in the model, but also in real life. Sometimes even after a good game, you won't have to make the journey in real life, because it would just be a repetition of experience you have already had. To play a game well, you need a balance between your willpower, which needs to be focused on your ultimate goal. What is the game a model of? You need to play with your heart, because you need to connect to the powers, to read their messages, to feel what the meaning is of an occurrence. And you need your mind a little bit to store all this information and to comprehend what is going on. Often there is a very clear symbolism. If you're playing chess, you have of course the pawns. The pawns are, you could say, the farmers. The powers which nourish you, which support you. If you lose all your pawns, it shows that you have not enough energy to feed you, to support you in your goal. The tower is very much a symbol of stability, of might, of overview. It is very connected to the stability of the will, of being focused, being stable. The horse is very much about passion. It's about using your passion, using your fury, using your emotion in a positive sense. The bishop is the symbol of your spirituality, your knowledge, your wisdom. The queen is the cosmos. It's the spiritual reality which is all around you, all the powers which are at the beck and call of, in a way, the king. The king is your own spirit or your own soul.